This PSA was brought to you by the Peter G Show.
You may have second thoughts after the show.
Don't drink the faucet.
We're really talented. We should get Oscars.
Just pick out a car, for Christ's sake.
No, I'm one. Hi, my name is Peter.
Yeah, I want.
Here's good.
Madam
Perry.
I need to get back in a genie bottle.
Louie from Pennsylvania, you're on.
He likes it.
It's showtime.
That's right, it's showtime. Happy Wednesday. Wednesday. I like Wednesdays. Like every day. Every day is good. But some people are very, oh, it's Monday. Can't wait for Friday. I'm just glad I wake up. How the hell is everybody? My name is Peter G. You're watching Life with Peter G, the Peter G Show, right here. Like clockwork, God willing, 6 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Central, and 9 p.m. on the East Coast. That's right. Right here. Glad to be here. Beautiful weather, at least for me. I don't know where everybody else is at. Some people, I guess, somewhere could be still seeing a little bit of snow somewhere if you live in Antarctica. But not here. Not now. It's nice. And I hope you're having a nice time, too. We got a extremely extra big show tonight. Gonna have Miss Cassandra Dunn on the show in just a few minutes. That's right, ETs, extraterrestrials. Are they real? Are they here? Cassandra has some knowledge about this topic, and she's gonna share some of it with us. And believe me, I got questions. I got questions. Take me to your leader. Anyway, but this is going to be a first, folks, okay? Look, we do a lot of stuff. But, you know, some people might think, you know, what the hell's going on with Peter? He's losing his rocker. Don't judge me. Talk to me after this show is over. I think every show we bring on, you learn something. There's something that that is definitely, you know, informative. Entertainment with a purpose, folks. Right here. That's right. That'll be coming up in a few minutes. But first, a reminder, as always, my beloved YouTube, I'm asking you people, please. I know you're on different platforms watching, and I know that we're doing a lot on a lot in a lot of places. But my YouTube needs more subscribers because when they wiped me out, I had to start all over again, and it's been hell. Just getting people to come on back over there. Just go over there to Peter G Show on YouTube and hit the subscribe button. You can watch it from there or you can watch it from anywhere. But just, I got to get the numbers up over there. They punished me severely. I say this every week, but I have to because different people tune in and different people listen. And it's important. They won't let me grow until you get to a certain number. And they really are, you know, throttled me down and throttled me back for saying things back in 2020 and 2021 and a little bit of 2022, and they punished me because they, you know, in my opinion, I had people on talking the truth, but you know how this, well, at least a lot of people believe that in this world we're living in right now, it's conquer and divide, and so there's a lot of mixed opinions and fact checkers and all this, but who's really talking the truth? Tune in, I'll tell you. But anyway, please, go to YouTube, hit the subscribe button, Peter G Show, boom. Free, easy. And again, for those that are true blue Peter G Show fans and watch the show, but sometimes you just can't because you got to go somewhere, you're at work, your schedule changes. I get it, totally get it. Google Peter G Show podcast, take the show on the road with you. And there's 25 different podcast platforms, Amazon Music, Spotify, Apple Podcasts. You just over, you know, it's almost 300 shows. Okay. all different topics. This is going to be the first for this topic, but you'll be able to listen to it. And it's the next best thing to be in here. And I promise you, total enjoyment and information that, you know, you may need to have or pass on that information to others. Believe me, you're not alone. And we just share stories. So please do that. Please, please, please do that. I can see what we're doing over here. Okay, listen. So I want to bring Cassandra on in just a couple of minutes here. But first, before we do that, we need to hear from my good friends over at Clean Star Products with their DX1 driver fuel additive. Saves you money and gas. And who doesn't want to save money? I'll be right back.
Hello, I'm Tyrone Thompson of CleanStarProducts.com. This is DX1 Driver in the news, and here's what our friends have to say.
So I'm here to recap on a DX1 I've used. I put it in oil and I put it in the gas while I'm using it just for about 3 tanks. Cleaned everything out. I got every ounce of power back in my truck.
When Jared's truck was new, it had a lot of power. Then over time, it began to slow down. He got it all back with our DX1 driver program.
Something you gotta see for yourself. It's a great product, it's affordable, and it blows all the other additives and esters out of the water.
DX1 driver is the finest oil in the world from a California environmental company. It goes into the fuel system and the oil. It's the only green grade product qualified for the carbon credits program, giving you better fuel mileage, lower emissions, and increased horsepower. So join the fuel savings revolution today. Go to cleanstarproducts.com/shop.
That's right, folks. Clean Star Products. Let me tell you something. This little bottle, it works. And if it can pass California emissions and all that crap, because California, they're making it tougher and tougher to even breathe over here. But if it can pass California, it can pass anything. Invest in your car. Take care of your car. Save money. Let's face it. Gas is expensive. Cars are expensive. This helps you save money and fuel. Pour this into a clean oil change. It lasts the whole oil change. Then a little bitty bottle into every fill up of your fuel and save up to 10% in fuel economy and give your engine more lubricity, less friction, lower emissions, more horsepower. It works. If you want more information, just go to cleanstartproducts.com and talk to them. They'll answer you and give you whatever the information you want. And all I can tell you is it works. Tell them the Peter G Show sent you. That'll do it. All right. Now, the moment you've been waiting for. Again, we've never done this on this show, and first time for everything, and I think there's a reason for everything, and that reason today is that we are going to talk to Miss Cassandra Dunn. Ladies and gentlemen, Cassandra Dunn. How are
Glad
you?
Glad to be here, Peter. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for taking the time. I know that we've actually been in touch for a couple of years now.
We have.
I think so. It feels like it's at least a good year and a half, almost 2 years, but conflict in schedules and things like that. But we finally managed to make this work, and I'm really glad for that. And on top of that, again, it's always been an interest of mine. But first, before we even get started, I want you to just take a minute, and why don't you give our viewers just a brief synopsis of who you are, what you do, what you've been doing, and how long you've been doing it, and then I'm going to start with the questions, okay?
Very good. So I've been a registered nurse for decades. I'm a holistic healer. I also was a certified federal medical investigator. I did investigations for the state and feds years ago. Currently, I still work as a registered nurse. I work in a very high-level, secure facility. I am not allowed to say in public where I work because I'm not a spokesperson for the Bureau, but I will say that I do work in a very high-level, secure facility in the United States. With that, I've also been traveling and volunteering on my spiritual growth. I've volunteered at East SETI Ranch that's owned by James Gilliland. He's pretty famous in the UFO spiritual realm on the internet. He has a 80-acre ranch at the base of Mount Adams in Trout Lake, Washington. So I volunteered for him for about a year and a half. I lived on the ranch. I've also traveled to Brazil to the House of St. Ignatius, which is known in the media as the John of God Healing Center. I started going there in 2012. I've been there 17 times. I've lived there at times. That's where my spiritual mediumship and connection with the divine and beings of light started back in 2012. And I've had many hundreds of experiences with that. I've connected people that needed healing with the entities of light. I've got lots of stories and experiences with that. I did share a picture of their light ship, a picture that was taken above the healing center right when it was closing at about 5 minutes to eight at night. I've worked at UFO conferences. I've done presentations. You can Google my name and my website to see some of my videos. I've also got a YouTube channel, Purple Lion Project. And I've also got a website where I share some things at www.purplelineproject.com. So I've got a lot of experience in healing in both ways. And so, yeah, with this show, you'll just get a tip of the iceberg. That's what I can say.
Okay. But here's the thing. So, you know, basically tonight we're going to be talking about ETs, extraterrestrials, okay?
Yes.
Now, a lot of people are going to say, Peter, bunch of nonsense, okay? Bunch of nonsense. We've been hearing about this crap for years, you know, and now I have somebody as yourself that's going to come on and say that this does exist, but why don't you tell me how they exist or where, or, you know, and then I'm going to start hitting you with some questions to try to break it. I mean, because, you know, people say, okay, if they exist, where the hell are they? I mean, you know, because how do you keep a secret about anything? So.
Well, that's a loaded question. It is by design that people are to be made fun of. It's a joke. So that is programming from those running the planet to prevent people from realizing that they are here. They don't want us to know. So they made a joke out of it. So when you say extraterrestrials, to me, they are our star family. Extraterrestrials is kind of just a word, a label. It really doesn't explain who and what they are. They are our star family. They are beings out in the galaxy. They are interdimensional. So you can't really learn about what extraterrestrials are or our star family or beings of light or other beings are until you start tapping in and becoming a little bit spiritual with it. There are some extraterrestrials, our star family, on the planet currently. I have met them face to face. I have met Tashina from Arcturus. I've hung out with her on the in a Native Indian reservation outside of Phoenix for a weekend. I met her. I was working at a UFO conference outside of Phoenix. And that is just one example. She looks human. Most of them do. That's where we get our genetics from. So a lot of the extraterrestrials do look like us. They're humanoid.
But Cassandra, look, now here's where the Peter the Meanie comes in the bag, you know, but I have to ask these questions that way I can get the great answers from you.
You go right ahead.
A lot of people are going to say, they're going to call bullshit because they're going to say, if there's people or extraterrestrials on this planet and you're hanging out with them or whatever, how is it that it's just still such a big secret? I mean, how the hell can they keep it to where it's so low profile and really not even talked about because nobody even cares? I mean, how do you explain that?
That's a great question. It's dangerous for the extraterrestrials to make a big presence because there are military forces that attack them. It's dangerous. Those running the planet do not want humanity to know on a full scale that we are not alone. And so when they come in and when they expose themselves, they are attacked. For example, Miss Tashina was telling me, when the government found out she was here, they abducted her and did an autopsy on her while she was alive to see how her organs were, how they were different. And they tortured her. It was a very traumatic experience. So it's dangerous. It's one of those lies that the governments do not want you to know. They will take it to the end. They will never admit that they are here. And so it's people like me and Starseeds that are now coming out, because now is the time to start disclosure and to reunite with our star family and reintegrate.
Okay. But here, you're telling me that this person that you know, they took her and did an autopsy on her. Is she still alive or she... dead?
She's still alive.
How'd she live, and what'd they do? They just let her go? Here, you can go now?
Yep, they did. And they did. And they followed her and they harassed her. And finally, she brought in her starship and said, you follow and harass them. And finally, she told me one day they knocked at her door and say, hey, can you call these people off, your ship off? She said, no, leave me alone. The government knows they're here. They know they're here. I have met several of them face to face. They know they're here.
Look, I don't doubt for one bit that we're, you know, in a whole universe, galaxies and this and that, I can't imagine that we're the only beings, you know, out of all these planets but to travel, we can't seem to get off this planet very easily. And then you're getting, look, you know, people can knock TikTok all they want and say that, you know, there's some real stuff on there I'm getting better news from TikTok that because they're not getting squashed or censored than I am from any place else, believe it or not. You know, I hate to say that, but it's the truth. Sure, there's a lot of stupid stuff on TikTok too, but depends where you go looking. Now, right. I pay attention to a lot of these people who claim that there's, you know, that there's been aliens on this planet for, you know, ages, and that they're living in underground mountains and caves. And but again, my point being, how can they go unseen? And I don't care if the military is keeping it a secret or not. They can't keep a secret for nothing. And all of a sudden, for this, they can keep it a huge secret.
They're trying. And that's their goal, that they're trying. So let me share a quick experience I've had. I used to live by Area 51 in Nevada. When I started moving out that way and traveling, I started connecting with beings on the base telepathically. So a lot of our extraterrestrial family, they communicate via telepathy, energy frequency. And so I was communicating with being, and I was asking particular questions. How do you heal someone from this illness? And I would get an answer. Well, one day I was traveling by the base and I was hit with some type of energy weapon that knocked my energy out. The only thing I could do was pull over to the side of the road, crawl in the back of my van and fall asleep. Well, when I woke up, there was an alien gray right outside my window. So the beings are here. There are some extraterrestrials that have been on the planet. They've been working with our government. I met Laura Eisenhower, President Eisenhower's great-granddaughter, years ago. And she's sharing in all the UFO conferences, all the spiritual conferences, of what her great-grandfather, how he connected with ETs, extraterrestrials, and made treaties for technology to get Kevlar, bulletproof vests, LED, high technology, in exchange for them abducting some people and giving a list to the government of who they've abducted. And they were supposed to return the people safely in a healthy state back in there, wherever they took them from. So Laura Eisenhower is also going around speaking and sharing what her great-grandfather experienced. So yes, our government is working with some factions of non-human beings.
Okay, but now I want to step it back, because all of a sudden you said that you're able to do mental telepathy. Where did that come from? I mean,
it's something that I have been tapping into for years. I've been prepping my body with certain nutrients. I eat healthy. I've decalcified my pineal gland with skate liver oil, fermented skate liver oil. I drink ASEA every day. I eat healthy foods. I don't eat fast food. I cleanse my body. I started doing this many years ago when I started going down to Brazil to the Healing Center. I started receiving messages. I could hear them. So I have processed and worked on being a spiritual medium. We all have it, but you're told you don't. I mean, I'm nobody special.
Okay, but I've had this. Hold on. I've had mediums on my show, but we talk about medium stuff, you know, talking with spirits that are past and things like that. Yes. Never have I had a medium that says that they talk to alien beings.
Yes.
I mean, you know, okay. So, I mean, and I got to tell you something, because again, trying to get you on this show and, you know, at first I'm going, I don't know, maybe this woman's, you know, a little bit, you know, high strung or just, you know, one too many tequila shots or something. And then I had a conversation with your husband, as I said, and he said, listen, I hear what you're saying. He says, but I too was questioning it and I married her, but I've seen it for myself. He claims that he's witnessed, saying, what has he witnessed with you?
Well, bringing him into my journey a couple years ago has opened up his spiritual process and growth. And what I have found out that he's part of God's army coming into their power at this time. We live in very exciting times right now. And so, so he sees with me what I go through. For example, I'd like to bring in Cynthia Crawford, if I may. Cynthia Crawford, I met her back in 2014. I was working at a UFO conference outside of Phoenix. She walked up to me and gave me this statue. This is a statue of Sekhmet. She's a lion being, and they were here on the planet back in the days of the pyramids, and you can see their statues of the lions. So she handed me this statue. She was known as ET sculptor. So she made ET art. And what she was two-thirds genetic ET DNA, one-third human. Her father worked for a dark military program. She was created using extraterrestrial genetics. And she had all these abilities. And the purpose of the government doing this, they wanted to create super soldiers, but it kind of backfired on them. So she used her abilities to bring in the star seeds. And what she did is she made different sculptures of different races of ETs. She made about 18 different races. And she was directed on who to give these sculptors to. I was one of them. She walked up to me out of the blue and said, here, hold this. She said, just hold it for a minute. She says, yep, that's for you. What this is my connection energetically. It's like my GPS to my star family. And I initiated it a few weeks ago. And guess who showed up coming through my front door was Mother Sekhmet and her entourage. And she came in and she stood in front of me as we bowed to each other. Even though she is considered a god in history, a goddess, we are all equal. And what she told me is contact has begun. A reuniting. And so this is a safe time now where star seeds like me can start coming out, sharing information, beginning with you, Peter, that our star family is real. And they're looking for people to contact.
Well, I wouldn't think they'd have a hard time contacting. Listen, but I want to back it up again. But you okay, because I have a picture of this woman you're talking about.
Yes.
And is she alive?
She passed away in 2017. And that is the moment See, I've always had great intuition. Intuition is where it's at. It's the subtleness that you have to tap into. A lot of men, you'll find, are kind of cut off energetically right here at the heart chakra. If you go to spiritual conferences, if you go to spiritual centers, if you go, it's mostly women. It's mostly women by design, because they cut you guys off. But yes, my intuition said, take that picture as she walked up to me. That's when she gave that to me, my gift. This is a wonderful gift.
But you're telling me this woman that we're looking at right here, you're telling me is a hybrid. She is
correct.
Part extraterrestrial, part human being.
Absolutely.
And what did she die from?
She died from a brain tumor back in 2017. Her work was done. She passed out all of her artworks to the appropriate humans on the planet that were worthy, that had worked on truth, love, unconditional love. Believe me, Peter, I've had a lot of experiences, and some of them weren't always very pleasant. I was attacked. My shoulder was dislocated, ribs pulled out. My neck was jacked. I was attacked from an interdimensional demon trying to make a hit on me. So with that, my star family came with their technology and they healed everything.
Where did this happen and how did you survive? I mean, where did this take place at?
This took place in Brazil.
Again, I'm just trying to answer, you know, get answers for the people, the normal people who are going, come on, you know, again, it's all fantasy or pop, you know. And look, again, I don't doubt that we're not alone. There's too many weird things going on. My whole thing is, it's just like, it's just so fantastic sounding. And how the hell they can just keep all this under wraps? It seems like it. Again, you know, they can't keep nothing a secret, and yet they're going to keep something as big as this, you know, down and. And I don't get, you know, that's why I have all these questions. It's just fascinating.
No, I understand completely.
I mean, I don't get any kind of signals or anything like that. And I kind of say, well, whatever happens, happens. But, you know, is there obviously, so now you're telling me there's good and bad.
Yes, there is. Absolutely. And more so of the bad ones are on the planet currently.
Wonderful. Figures. And so what do we do about it? I mean, you know, what's that going to lead to? Obviously, just like what's going on with our crime going on, you let crime create crime and you don't do anything about it. And we're in a mess.
You know, the best movie you can see for some good answers is that one. Oh, shoot. It'll come to me in a minute. There's a movie out called Jupiter Ascending. It's a fictional movie, but I tell you, lots of truths in there. Watch it.
I find that most movies have a lot of truth.
Have a nugget of truth because they have to show you the dark, the deep state, the reptilians, the Dracos, the tall grays. They do have to follow some sort of galactic law and karma. So they have to put out in front to show the public, this is what we're going to do. This is what we're all about. And if nobody says, no, I don't consent, then they feel that's our consent with just compliance. So
how's that work? I mean, that's they know what they don't know the difference between right or wrong, correct?
They do, but they don't follow what's right. They're very self-centered. That's why the beings that I deal with, a lot of people ask me, how do you know they're good? Because they allow free will. So anytime I have sent my entities of light that I have connected with through the healing center in Brazil, they always show up in the hospital room or in their bedrooms of those that ask me for help. And the first thing they say is it okay if we take over your plan of care? Right? They don't push themselves. They don't make things fearful. They don't have any demands. And so I work with entities of light that are in service to others. And that's how I live my life. Everything that I've done to help with healing, connection is free of charge. I sell nothing. I don't charge for anything. God doesn't charge.
But okay, but what purpose do they have here, or and what do they want with us? I mean, you know, I mean, are we like animals, like animals that are animals to us, that to the bad ones, so to speak? Are we just, you know, they don't really care?
Well, I'll tell you what the dark ones think we are. They think we're cattle. Look at your birth certificate. They think we're cattle. They eat our babies. 8 million children go missing every year around the planet. Where do you think they go? Yeah, a small percentage of it is about family issues, parental arguments, sure. But no, most of them are taken off planet to be slaves or raped or eaten, or taken underground to be slaves or eaten and have these horrific experiments done on. That is all being taken down right now.
What do you mean by taken down?
That's what they think we are. We're food. They eat off our louche. They love it when there's wars because they eat off that energy. It's sick.
But what's okay? So then why doesn't our government say, hey, enough is enough?
Because they're participating in it.
What advantage is that?
Power, money, prestige, ego, Hollywood.
I see
something out of it. And then at the end of the day, most of them are drinking adrenochrome, which is like their heroin, their high. And that adrenochrome comes from labs like in the Ukraine that are being taken out. It's sick. These demons on the planet are sick, and they've been around for hundreds and thousands of years.
Okay, but you know,
so what do we do about it? We step into our power. Step into your power like I did. I say my affirmations. I connect with my star family. I connect with beings of light. I say my invocation, my pure perfection invocation on my Facebook page. I say my prayers of protection every day. Every day I have this in my wallet. I've got that on my YouTube page. You have to ask for help, for divine protection from these higher level beings that are of service to others. Unconditional love. They don't violate your free will. They will not come to you unless you invite them in, because that's a galactic law. Law of interference. They will not interfere unless you allow them in.
But the bad ones will.
Oh, the bad ones don't care about your free will. What's been going on for the last couple years?
Okay, but again, you know, to think that this stuff now, you know, again, I'm very open-minded, and I watch a lot of this stuff. I just don't talk about it a whole lot. I mean, what do the good, the grays, or this and that, since they're here, what are they doing about? I mean, they're just sitting back and just, oh, sorry, you just got to deal with it?
Well, I mean, they're not going to interfere with a growing civilization. They have always been here assisting and observing, but this reality was created out of free will. It's a school. It's a lesson. What is it a lesson in? It's a lesson in never giving your power away. It's a lesson in remembering who you are. Who are we? We are divine beings made by Source. I did a brief Facebook video on what that means. So I know time is limited, but it means bringing that in, bringing in your divinity. We are masters. That's what we are. Say no. Do not consent. If you knew what I did where I work, it took some balls, let me tell you. Putting high level people on notice.
Kind of notice.
Do something. That's the time is now. Do something. Say no.
I think we're in a time that we have a lot of sheep, a lot of people that just
float. Yes, we do.
And think, and I hate starting it's not an argument, but nope. A lot of people think we're just fine. We're doing fine. And, you know, we're very divided right now, and I hate it.
You know what? You know what? And that's okay, because I honor their journey. This is the time. I was told that the split in this reality is here. The ascension is here. Those that have done their inner work, that are in service to others, that have a higher frequency of unconditional love and acceptance, will move forward. And with that process, you integrate into connecting with your star family, technology, healing, med beds, freedom from bills and the Federal Reserve BS. So that's where we're at. And I was told and connected at this time, because now is the time. You'll start seeing more and more comments that they're seeing a celestial plant body. There's a YouTube video, a channel that shows FAA cameras in Alaska, and it shows you this large celestial body in sight. But all the cameras are shutting it out. They don't want people to know. They don't want people to know that these are the end times for this experience. We are moving forward, and those people that are called sheep, some of them do not have souls. And Dolores Cannon called them backdrop people. And they will just pass on, stay with the old 3D reality, or just die. Now, those that do have souls that are not advancing, I honor their journey. They need more lessons of growth. And so it's not going to be good. That's all I have to say.
Look, I mean, you're saying, you know, to be receptive and love and things. So I think I have a lot of that in me, but yet I'm still seeing a lot of bills.
I know.
You know, I don't like,
but
my,
you know,
road.
It's a lesson. Like it's all a lesson. Everything is a lesson.
I got a lot of lessons.
Everything is a lesson. So what was that lesson? When Jesus flipped the money tables over, he knew money is the root of all evil.
Let me ask you this now, that since you mentioned our friend, do you believe in God?
Absolutely. I was taken out of body in 2019. I was astral traveling. I went to source. Now, when people ask me if I believe in God, the first thing I say is, what God are you talking about?
Yeah, what is God?
Well, God is many things. We have prime creator, source of all that is. I was taken out of body, astral traveled to source in 2019. It's a big ball of bright white light that emits love. That is all it is. And so I was taken out of body in, to see source. I gave thanks. I prayed. I cried. I was sent back. I messaged all my loved ones that I was sent to source. I received the message. I have a unique soul. I have confirmed this with many mediums, psychics. My soul comes directly from source. I'm on a specific mission to share his unconditional love with humanity. And so with that special energetic frequency, I have attracted all these experiences, these people, and my life has been great most of the time. I did have some suffering back in 2012. I was offered hospice. That's when they came and did some immediate intervention on my physical body, and they showed up. But
you know, a lot of people believe in God or don't. I have a lot of people who don't believe in anything. They think, let me ask you this, when you die, what do you think happens to you when you die? Because I have friends that think you just become worm food and that's it. You're done and over. And they believe that. And I said, well, one day we're going to all find out. And I figure I might as well stay on the positive end of it than to just think that that's the end of that.
That's very sad. That is very sad. That's fear-mongering programming by people running the planet for many years. When this physical container dies, you transition into a higher frequency and your consciousness becomes expanded. You are reunited with your loved ones that have passed. My grandmother has come back to see me and give me a message probably in 2013. I was astral traveling and she came to me, gave me a message. She had passed like 15 years earlier. I've connected with many deceased. I went to Lavoie Finicum's funeral. You know, the guy that was shot in the head by the FBI because they're stealing his ranch land in Nevada. I went to his funeral, and he approached me spiritually. I went up to his casket. There were thousands of people there. I was so upset, and I said, I'm sorry, I can't come up with a prayer. And he put his arm around me. He said, it's okay. It's okay. I'm good. It's okay. So I have connected many times with those that have been deceased. You never, ever die. And shame on the programmers that planted that fear into humanity, because it's all over fear and control. And when you're in a state of fear, your vibration is low, you can't think right, and you're a tool, you become a slave.
Yeah, but Cassandra, a lot of people I know that I think it's just family upbringing. They bring their beliefs that what they were brought up on, you know, I mean, and yeah, that's just what they believe, and they don't know any better. Look, I believe in, I mean, I really, really hope that, you know, I'm correct in this whole fashion, but even though I hate losing people here, and I actually like life, I like life a lot, you know, and it, to me, I'm sad if, you know, if when this all ends one day, but then again, that's as far as I know right now, but
that's all you're supposed to know right now. If you knew the answers to every question you had, what would be the sense of school? We're here for a purpose. Everything is a test. It's a journey. It's a journey of finding yourself. And then eventually, when the time is right, you go home. This is not home. That's home. And your soul never dies, ever.
I'm going to have a long talk with myself one day, because I don't think I needed this. I really could have done without it. I want to backtrack, because there's other things I want to get to. And you know, this whole alien thing, okay? Because spirituality and spirit, one thing, but the grays and this and that. Now, here's a picture of this guy. I don't know his name, but I've seen him on TikTok a lot. You know who I'm talking about?
Yes, that's Captain Randy Kramer of the United States Marine Corps Special Services Unit, Secret Space Force for 17 years.
Okay, Secret Space Force. This guy claims that there's moon base. I mean, there's you know, bases on Mars, and he's been there and all that kind of stuff. Now we're getting to the crazy stuff, because it's hard to believe. Please explain.
So for many decades, probably back into the 40s and 50s, back into the Nazi era, they were connecting with ETs, getting technology in their Nazi Bell and their building of their spaceships. Oh, yeah, there's bases on Mars. I met a captain of the Apollo space program, and he showed me his personal binder of pictures of our bases on the moon. So us as taxpayers are paying for all this. And, you know, where's all the drug money going? It's going to these black op projects so that Congress doesn't have to reveal that via a FOIA. So they get money from other sources to fund these black projects. Black projects meaning unknown to the public, secret. So yeah, they've been funneling trillions of dollars from us, because that's what we are. We're just feed cattle for our energy and our tax monies. And we fund all these bases, and they've got the technology. Captain Randy Kramer, the picture you just showed, I spent a weekend with him at Isetti Ranch, and I picked him up at the Portland airport, and we spoke one-to-one, and he was healed in a med bed. He had an arm blown off. So med beds are real. They just won't release them to the public for healing, because pharma is making too much money off the pain and suffering of humanity. So me, okay, I always use healing from the divine, from the beings of light I connect with. I also use healing from natural sources, herbs, fish oil, ASEA, things like that.
I know, but you can't grow another arm using that. I mean, not that we know of.
Not here. That, no. But the med beds are available. They are here. They just will not release them to the public. And Captain Randy Kramer has lots of videos on YouTube and other places where he shares his experience.
Here's my point. This guy is all over. I've seen, believe me, I've watched a bunch of, you know, sections of interviews with him talking all this stuff. How the hell do you keep something of this mass, the moon, Mars, when we got people saying that we got flat Earth or there's a dome over Earth, like you can only get out so far. I have a personal engineer friend of mine. I used to play music with him when we were younger. And he's an engineer out here in California who helped develop that helicopter that went on to Mars, supposedly, to fly around to get aerial views. I mean, if I tell him something like this, in fact, I kind of did. And he just looked at me, goes, "You got to be kidding me." So you got these engineers here. How do you keep such a secret? Why are they sending things somewhere that, you know, if it's already there and bigger?
Yeah, I don't have a really good answer for you.
It's, I mean, just, the secret. How do you keep it a secret?
They do not want humanity to know, because if we did, we would be very dangerous to them. We would have healing. Religion would collapse. The bankers would collapse. Pharma would collapse. The entire global matrix would collapse. It's like they're playing whack-a-mole with the truthers. Anything that comes out, bang, you're dead, right? There's a lot of these people that are exposing stuff that wind up suicided.
Well, here's my point. Like, this guy's out here telling everybody, and he's one of the many. There's all these people with all these experiences and telling things. How come they're not being, you know, silenced, so to speak, or why are they allowed to go out and tell this stuff? Because I see tons of it on TikTok and things like that.
It'll never go mainstream. Mainstream media will never show any of this.
I think
people start to gain a momentum, they watch you. If you gain a momentum, you'll get a visit. Or it depends on what you're exposing, because they're busy. These guys are busy trying to follow all the truthers and playing whack-a-mole. And it's like, oh God, we got to get rid of this guy that exposed one of the ingredients that was a contaminant and you know what. And they got rid of all of them. They all died.
I just think that, like, this guy's out there a lot. And I see other people as well that are talking about they went down into some cave with armed military. Yes. And there was, you know, a tall grays and it was dark and all these things. And I'm going, how are they allowed to say this stuff and get away? You know,
that's a great question. Do you see this amulet I have on?
Yeah.
This is my armor of God. I have been verified and told by many people that I am highly protected. If you knew what I did for a living at my work, you'd be shocked.
Who are you doing your work for? The government?
Yes. So I wear my armor of God every day. I say the prayer of armor of God. I say my prayers of protection. I say my Psalm 23 every day. Right? So I have unseen protection around me. And that's what I have to do on a daily basis, every day. Every day I put this on and I have faith in God.
Well, how is it you're able to do what you can't tell me that you're doing? And yet you're out here. I mean, here you are on talking all this stuff and that's okay.
Well, I have a meeting on Wednesday. Let's just put it that way.
Working?
Yeah.
I have
a meeting Wednesday, and I've got my homework. I know my stuff. I'm going to tell you that, Peter G. I know my stuff. I'm intelligent. Okay. I'm wise. I'm 56 years old. I've got lots of experience. I've had lots of connections. I've had lots of training on and off planet. Now is the time. I speak truth.
Well, look, your story doesn't sound too much different than a lot of the interviews that I've watched. I mean, the stories are all similar. But again, now, look, I want to play a video. This is something you don't know I have. And I just found it because I found it like a day or two ago. And I want you to see this and then you tell me and then we'll talk about it. So just check this out.
Ranch. It's a one-of-a-kind piece of property that just went up for sale in Buckeye.
And its owner says whoever buys it will likely have a lot of unwelcome guests. Lauren Reimer went to check it out tonight.
We have four bedrooms in the house.
This seemingly peaceful Buckeye Horse property was recently put on the market.
We have a 10-foot deep diving pool.
According to its owner, John Edmonds, Stardust Ranch also has one quality you won't find anywhere else.
Well, we have two alien portals. We have one in the front and one in the back.
And through those portals, he says they often get otherworldly visitors.
The grays, unfortunately, that we have run into in the house and on the property are anything but peaceful.
He says he has the scars to prove it.
I've killed 19 of them here on the property.
So after 20 years of defending his property from extraterrestrials,
they have large black bulbous eyes.
Edmonds and his wife say it's time to move.
It's going to go to somebody that understands the true nature of what's here.
The property is listed for $5 million. Its owner says it's going to take a special kind of buyer to take on the amenities that come with it.
In a way, we're offering a university. It's a place for teaching. It's a place for learning.
I'm Lauren Reimer for Arizona's Family.
True or false?
I was invited to his ranch years ago, but I knew intuitively not to go. It's a dark place. You're asking for trouble.
But he's saying they're grays.
Yeah, there's different types of grays. There's tall grays. There's short grays. There are grays that are biological entities that don't have a soul. Now, mind you, there are some star families with technology millions of years in advance, right? Millions. Yeah. Can you imagine? Okay. So some of the grays are not actually living. They're biological beings. So there's different types of grays. And it appears that the beings that are coming through his portals at his ranch don't have your best interest in mind. And I surely wasn't going to go ask for trouble.
Okay. But he said he's killed 19 of them since he's been there, which is almost 20 years. Where's the bodies? I mean, what does he do with them? You know, where do they go? There's just like all these little pieces that I'd like to understand. I mean, I'm not saying it's not true, but I don't get it.
It's just like Bigfoot. I sent you a picture of Bigfoot. Bigfoot is real. They're spiritual beings. They're way advanced than us. They're interdimensional. They can come and go in the physicality. And so the picture I sent you in his purple energy was Bigfoot in his spirit energy. Because I was trying to connect with Bigfoot when I lived on the ranch at East City Ranch in Washington State. There's a lot of sightings of Bigfoot in Washington. So I put the intention out there that I would like to hug one. I would like to meet one. So as I was walking back to my campsite in the middle of the night, it was very dark. It said, hey, take a picture to your left. So I took a picture to my left. I go back to my campsite, look at my pictures for the day, and lo and behold, there is his face in the purple energy. So I can't speak for the Stardust Ranch on what happened to the beings that he claims he killed. The government is cleaning this stuff up. They're squashing it. I can't speak for Stardust Ranch, but all I do know is that it's real. And I was invited to go there, and I said, no, thanks.
Okay, because, I mean, now the guy's on the news telling everybody, you know, so who's going to buy that? That's like buying a haunted house, so to speak. And why there for 20 years? Like, if they're so advanced in technology, they got to constantly stay right there? You know what I mean?
Well, there's energetic portals in different places, and so...
When it made the news, I mean, that's on Arizona local right. news. So right. it's like so much for the secret, you know, and again, if the government's watching, they have to know, I would imagine they would know. And so, you know, again, a lot of loose questions that makes you doubt.
Sure.
It just, you know, and I mean, again, I just, there's no way I'm going to believe that, that there's, you know, that there's not other life anyplace else, but it just kind of makes it kind of hard because after all these years, despite the few stories, Roswell and all this kind of stuff, and we see people with sightings, but yet it's not like there's no purpose. There just doesn't seem to be any purpose to it.
So I think currently, once you post this open to comments. I bet you you're going to have a lot of people starting to say, you know what, I saw a UFO when I was a little kid, or I had a weird experience. It's opening up the conversation and not being laughed at or belittled. Because I run into a lot of people that say, thank you for sharing that, because I had a weird experience of so-and-so and this happened. And so people approach me all the time saying, thank you. You're opening up the conversation.
I get it. And again, I've had a couple of things. I grew up in Pensacola, Florida, and Gulf Breeze, Florida. Back in the 80s, there was a bunch of sightings, so to speak, that made the news. And then it kind of went away after several years. But in fact, I had a neighbor whose son claims he was driving in that area and got abducted. And he disappeared for days. And then he just showed back up. He wrote a book on it. And I got that book somewhere. And it's in boxes. It's probably been sitting for 30 years now. And I never finished reading that book because at the time I was in my 20s. And my father told me stories that he has told. That man ended up dying of cancer. And my father believes that they told him to shut up and he wouldn't. And they kind of, you know, made him sick and he died. I mean, these are just stories, but he wrote this book and it was, you know, he didn't name things by names, but he wrote a story about this and through other characters. And I swear I got to get it out and read it one of these days. But again, I don't not believe these things, but it is pretty fantastic sounding.
It is.
And I'd like to find the purpose. I'd like to see some good come from all this.
Oh, it's coming. It's coming. So again, part of our journey in this on this planet was being separate. That was the whole, that's one of the purposes of the school here, is being separated from God, being separated from our star family, being behind the veil. It's a journey of learning. So it's learning to be independent as a soul for soul growth. One thing I would like to mention is I was sent to a UFO conference out east. I can't remember if it was I think it was North Carolina many years ago. The guy putting on that UFO conference had cancer all over. And so I connected him with the beings of light. And he says, you know, come on out and I'll you can hang out with us. And I got to meet a lot of UFO speakers from around the world, some high-level generals from South America that shared with me their experience with UFOs coming and hovering over the nuclear missile websites that disabled them. They will not allow a full-out nuclear war.
Well, that'd be a good thing because we're so close. You know what I mean?
See,
I think we're close.
We're close because that's what the media wants you to think. They want you to be in a state of fear.
Sure.
Everything is fear-driven. And it lowers your vibration. It shuts your consciousness down when you're in a state of fear. You can't think right. You can't analyze right. So fear is their game. Fear is their game, and you have to match it with love and faith that God has your back, because that's what it's all about. Yeah, fear.
You're preaching to the choir, but again, we're going to be. I know that I'm going to encounter people through time, and they're going to, you know, and people are going to, because again, all these conventions and all these people from all over the world that converge together to talk about the same things in different places. How the hell has it not just full blown? I just thought that's what blows my mind, because I mean, it's almost like, you know, going viral or something like that. It's like, how can you take so many people with this stuff and yet there's some people that are just in the dark about this and it's not a big deal. And it's like, that's poppycock.
Well, I'll give you my opinion. My opinion is that they are allowing us our journey as humans on planet Earth. They are allowing our evolvement. And they will reconnect when the time is right, when it's safe, when enough souls have awakened, and during the ascension process. So that's my opinion on where it's going from here out. I get the intuition that as each month goes by, you will see more and more things show up on the mainstream news. The banks are collapsing, the this and the that. Oh, this is exposed. Oh, guess what? Your vice president never signed an oath of office to the Constitution. Oh, as a matter of fact, most of the government people didn't, right? So you're going to find exposure and then disclosure, right? So people need to be awakened that everything is fakery. Everything is an illusion. It's a lie. And so you'll see, oh, as the months go by, it will be exposed.
That's the tough one.
That is going to be real tough.
Why would this is what I feel, and I say it on so many of these shows that we have because it's so pertinent. I understand people for saying, why would they lie to us? You know, why? And that's a big one to get over. Once you can get over that, you're home free because you start looking at other things. But I have so many people that I love to death, near and dear to, but they are so shut off. And I was that guy 8 years ago, maybe little by little. You know, it just finally dawned on me and I started paying attention and questioning now everything. But the thing is, I don't go deep into the rabbit hole to where it consumes me, but I'm pretty aware of what the hell is going on and trying to just, you know, navigate through these times right now. But I understand people for going like the news. We're not in Iran. Why would they, you know, state? I know that there's always been deception and they, you know, but we're in Iran. You can understand that. It's like they tell you only what they want you to know. And that's that. We're living in the same thing. But it's hard to fathom that because we're the United States of America. So there's our problem. It's like people can't get over that mindset of like, there's no way they're lying to us. I'm following CNN or whatever news channel you follow. And that's the truth.
I was in the same boat, Peter. 20 years ago, I was all living in the matrix and blind to everything. It was a rude awakening that woke me up. But see, like me and you and others, we are all gaining momentum. And this is what they fear, because they see that we are gaining momentum into awareness, into stepping into our power, into connecting with the divine and our star family. And they knew this was coming. Oh, they knew this day was coming, and they are afraid. That's why you see the freak shows and how freaky everything's been. You know, I'm referring to Bud Light, Nike, and all this freaky stuff. Oh, yeah. So the freakier they get, the more distraction they're trying to put in, the more fear-mongering they get, the more ridiculousness they put out, is because they're in fear now, because we have arrived.
I just know that this show is going to go down and live on, and there's going to be plenty of people that are going, what the hell is going on with Peter? You know, with this bullshit, you know? And all I can say is I hope they just listen open-mindedly and just keep it in the back of their head, because the things are there if you want to pay attention to it. Or it's a conspiracy, and, you know, and we're full of nonsense, but, you know, that's the way it is.
Well, Peter, I have nothing to gain from sharing anything. I have nothing to gain. I don't ask for money. I don't make money doing this. I don't make money with my healing and connecting you with the divine beings that are here to help with healing. I've helped 400 to 600 people. I have nothing to gain. I am here to share pure truth with humanity.
Last question, and then unfortunately we're really, I'm already over right now, but I knew this was going to happen because it's endless. Have you ever heard of Bashar?
Yes.
What do you think of him?
I think Bashar is an incarnate tool. His mission is to be a channeler, someone to connect where his star soul came from and share with humanity. I did a post on Facebook just about him recently. It said Bashar even states that contact is starting in 2023. It resonated with me, so I posted it. So what you're going to find is more star seeds like Bashar, me, others that have their artwork, the other 18 races. You're going to start seeing us pop up here and there and here and there. And you're going to feel the frequency of the words that we're sharing to the public. I'm coming from a place of love, unconditional love, no judgment. If you don't believe anything I say, I honor your journey.
No,
I honor it. But
I like that guy's name is Daryl Anka or something like that. Yeah. And Bashar is supposedly the being that channels through Daryl, and he's been doing it since the late 70s, correct? Something like that.
He's been doing it a very long time.
I like him. Now, again, if I'm a sucker for this, this man is a genius, because I just don't think anybody is that friggin' smart to be able to in the way that it's coming out of him talking about certain things. You'd have to be an amazing science fiction, genius to come up with some of this stuff. And not saying that it can't be, but I probably will pay attention to him more than anybody, because it seems to be nothing harmful. You know what I mean?
There you go. You just hit it right on the head. Nothing harmful, fearful, belittling comes from him. He doesn't want anything from you. He's planting nuggets, seeds of something to think about. Go within, research, connect, integrate it.
The concept is tough. I mean, even the five laws. I mean, no matter how, I got somebody else who I'm very close with who's very spiritual, and she says, you got to keep working on yourself. You got to keep working on yourself. And that'd be great if you know exactly, if you kind of know what the heck you're working on. You know what I mean? I mean, at my best, I don't know if I'm working any good, because here I am living whatever the heck I'm doing and fighting the fight to be every day. But, just those five laws, I mean, it's deep. It's just like, you exist and all this kind of stuff. I don't know. It takes a lot of people. People have to really want to pay attention if they're going to follow that kind of stuff. But
okay. Again. So like I tell people, intention is everything. Intention. So thoughts are energy. That's why we do EEGs, right?
Yeah.
And EMGs. We're frequency based. So intention is everything. The universe is neutral. So how I live my life and how I bring in what I need, I send the universe my intentions. This is what I want to achieve for today. When I do my deep spiritual work, I give three intentions. I need this, this, and this. And I get it. Because the universe has all this knowledge. It is all knowing. And you have to pull it in. And unless you put out your focused intention, the universe brings you mishmash, confusion, no clarification, no direction. So you have to do your affirmations. You have to do your intentions, right? Put your intentions out. What do you want, right? And it's kind of the law of attraction in a way. But if you understand everything is energy, we are frequency. That's why we're being affected by certain frequencies that are being put out now. They've got frequency weapons.
See what I mean? Again, top secret stuff. I remember my father back in the day, like tsunamis and things that were happening. He's going, they have things to make that happen. And, again, I'm going, get the hell out of here. But I don't doubt there's disrupting thing, but again, how the hell do you keep those secrets? And I'm sure with space, even with the Trump, there's things going up, in satellites and stuff that, we don't know we have, that the average person doesn't know really what we have that works and all that. But all right,
So how they keep it a secret? They control the mainstream media. They have it down. MK Ultra, mind control programming. Yeah. They got it down. They know how the human consciousness works. They distract us, they confuse us, they put us in a state of fear, and they use the media to ingrain it and put it in there. The last 2 years showed you how brainwashed the people are and what they did to harm themselves.
Well, they scared the shit out.
They believed in the lies.
Look, I was out today, getting ready for today, and I'm still seeing people outside with a mask on. That's all because that's all they know. That's what was now instilled in them. I'm going, and I just want to shake them and go stop. But again,
I do too. But at the same time, I have been taught by beings of light, high level beings. I have been visited by Mary. I have been visited by very high level masters, and I have to be like them, patient, non-judgmental, and I have to allow others their journey. Even though they're harming themselves, I have to allow. If they ask for my help or my opinion, I will give it to them. But
I get it.
You have to allow. I've walked away from a lot of people, Peter, that I know I could have helped, but they don't want it. I cannot be like the dark and violate free will. So it goes back to unconditional love.
True. Again, but you know, there's only so much you can do, as you said. And my daughter calls it natural selection.
Part of that too, sure, right?
Yeah, it's like
right? And then when the physical body dies and they pop out of their body, they have a increased awareness. They meet with their guides. They have their life review, and they're going to be shown. Look what you did to yourself. You gave your power away.
But in the meantime, we got to deal with it. I got, look, see what I mean? This is the last question, very last question, because I'm going to get in so much trouble. 5G, cellular 5G. Before, earlier in the, 2020, when it was first popping out and everything, my Pepsi, my behind the scenes, and, he was like, the 5G, that's going to be used for mind control, that vibration, that electronic and all this kind of stuff. What's your take on that real quick?
All right, I will give you my opinion from what I've gathered. Because I follow all of this 24/7. When I'm not at work, I'm at home researching, watching, observing, reading, connecting. So my opinion on 5G, from what I have gathered, is that it's a weaponized frequency. Yeah. It does not create anything healthy. It disrupts your cells, your genetics, and in combination with something else, it may add additional harmful benefits.
Right. Different frequencies make.
I watched the group in front of Congress years ago. There's a video of it on YouTube, I believe. Verizon, Mobile T. There were four or five representatives from all the cell phone industries in front of Congress. And congressmen asked them, how much money have you spent on safety studies with 5G? You, sir, nothing. You, sir, zero. You, sir, nothing. They have done no safety studies by design, because those studies would show you that frequency is harmful to human and animal, all life health. So to me, it's dangerous. I never put that phone up to my ear. I use earbuds all the time. So I believe that this is part of the increase in cancers that we're seeing and other health issues that could be construed as, I can't say it because of the highly censorship, the disease that causes problems, breathing, fever, flu-like symptoms. It can cause the same issues. Now, from what I hear in Wuhan, China, people were dying in the streets. You don't die in the street of a virus. You die from a weapon. And from what I understand, 18,000 or more 5G towers were flipped on. And prior to that, all the Chinese residents were required to get something here. And all of a sudden, flip on and boom. You've got instantaneous death.
Again, we're going to have people, saying that's poppycock. They can't wait to get more because it's advertised on TV. Never have I seen such things. But again, I just was curious because I do understand energy, frequency, electrical. We're all electrical. And I just have this thing about, or I've been told by, I have somebody in Poland who's a very high end of the NSA and all this kind of stuff, and he's underground, and he's constantly talking to me about mind control and frequencies and just flipping certain frequencies to aid in making the process of making you ill in so many different ways undetected, why would they do that? And again, all the crazy talk starts in again. So okay, look, I as much as I want to keep going, I do, but we're going to have to pick this up another time. I want to tell people, if they want to follow you or anything like that, you said that you're on Facebook a lot. Is that true?
That's correct. I'm not very techie, so I do have a website. I'm still trying to figure out how to work it, but you can go to my website at www.purplelineproject.com. But most of the time, if you have a question or comment, suggestion, reach me on Facebook. I'm there more so. If I can, Peter, if I could share one more thing, is for those that are suffering the effects from this thing, or if you're suffering effects from shedders, if you're being affected by being around those people, I recommend getting the Cardio Miracle. Cardio Miracle. Again, I don't sell anything. I'm not making any money. I'm just sharing what I feel is working. Okay. At this time in our evolvement, we all just need to hang in there, because healing technologies are coming. The med beds are coming. The freedom is coming. The abundance is coming. The connections with our star family is coming. Just hang in there and don't poison yourself anymore.
I don't think they think they're poisoning themselves. And I think one day if they do get sick, it's going to be from something that they figure had nothing to do with it, because it's coming from a different avenue, which is showing up all over the place. But everybody says all bullshit, and I hate it. I hate it for them, but there's nothing you can do. I mean, you know, it is what it is. Okay. You can find Cassandra on Facebook at Cassandra S. Dunn. If you want to talk to her, give her your 2 cents, ask her questions, join her, you know, crew, whatever. She's right there. I thank you for giving me the time. I know we've, like I said, gone round and round with this, and it's been quite a journey just getting to this point, but here we are, and I do believe everything happens for a reason, so I'm glad we finally did this, and maybe we'll figure out another reason down the road for some other, but I try to keep it on point, even though we started going in and out, but at the end of the day, it all came back to one.
Great. And thank you, Peter. I appreciate you giving me the opportunity. And if you ever want to do a part two, you just let me know.
I will. When I become a galactic show host, I'm available.
You know what I mean? You ask for.
Well, you know what? I'm available, guys.
You're on the right track.
Okay, I'll tell my creditors that, but okay. You know.
All right.
Thank you so much. I love you for taking the time, and we'll be talking down the road. All right.
Thank you so much.
All right, last look at Cassandra. She waves on by, and I'll see you later. Here we go. Okay. I'm going to let everybody take that in for a minute while I get a drink, because I am thirsty. Woo! Smooth. Let me tell you. Okay, I'm going to get a lot of naysayers from this show, and I'm going to get a lot of people that would agree totally and 100%. Unfortunately, I can't please everybody. I've just been fortunate enough to be given this moment and to bring it to light. You can take what you want from it. You can contact Cassandra right there on Facebook. You can give her your peace of mind, or you can ask her for help. But either way, I do things because I share information. We share stories. Every story is not going to be agreeable to you. It's not going to be your story, and it may not completely relate, but I promise you, if you watch enough of these stories that we do here, that one way or another, I'm going to be relatable to you, and you're going to understand, and it'll all come together. But you have to be open to understand. If you disagree with the things I do and some of the things I bring to light, that's fine. All I ask is that you watch it with an open mind and don't just turn it off and go, oh, he's out of his friggin' mind. I already know I'm out of my mind. I don't need to that. I've been told that for years, but I still have a purpose. And that purpose is me being here. So I love all of you for watching. I want to remind you, share. That's number one. And number one, please go over to the YouTube and just hit the subscribe button. Again, I forever have to say this until we get going, because I need to up the game. We need to keep moving forward. All right. These shows, business is expensive, and it's always, I hate bringing money into the whole thing, but it takes money to be here. But I'm grateful. But show me your appreciation. It's free by just going and hitting the subscribe buttons and following and sharing. That much I would love you for, even more, although I love you a lot now. Again, if you're too busy to watch the show, I get it. Life is busy. Watch it when you can. The beauty is you can watch all these shows on demand. You don't have to be here for the live show. I love it when you are, though. But you can watch them all on demand. But if you can't watch, you're driving, I don't want you getting in an accident. I don't want to hear anything bad like that. Google Peter G Show podcast and just download the Amazon Music or Spotify. You know, there's 25 different platforms. You can listen to the shows on the go. You can listen to the shows while you're at work. Because again, work is boring unless you work here. Then it's kind of cool. But in fact, this is the easiest part of my job. It's the rest of the week that's killing me. And that's it. Okay. I love you guys. I really do. And I hope I brought you something of interest because it was interesting to me because I kind of pay attention to a lot of stuff. Don't say never say never. Crazier things have happened. And I don't like I told you so's, but I'm going to tell you so. When the time comes, I'm going to tell you I told you so, whether it's here in life or later on. It's like I told a friend of mine because he didn't believe in death, you know, life after death. I said, well, if I bump into you later, I said, you're going to get one of my finger pointings. That's it. Thank you for watching Life with Peter G, the Peter G Show. We just talked about all kinds of life tonight from a lot of different places. Every Wednesday, like clockwork, 6 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Central, 9 o'clock on the East Coast, right here, God willing. Love you guys. Life is tough. You don't have to take a lot of crap from people, but you don't have to be an ass either. You know, it's something I'm continually learning. Take a deep breath before you bark. Something I'm learning. And just try to be kind. Just try to be kind. And, you know, again, sometimes my buttons get pushed and it's like, you know, I don't let things go very easy. And I envy the ones who let things roll off of them. I really do. I'm working on it. I'm not a bad person. It just certain things bug me and it just takes me time to like get out of that mode. Doesn't mean I'm doing anything wrong. It's just we're all different, but just be kind. Again, I love you guys. My name is Peter G. I want to thank you for watching. And as always, I love you guys. Peace out.
Peter G Show. Peter G Show. Divorce Dad.